This episode of Good Times and Mo, the podcast, is brought to you by Globe.
It's not bragging if you back it up, right? In that case, welcome to the baddest show in the land.
You guys have so much sexual tension.
Where every question is answered.
Why is the moon following me?
And every challenge is met.
I will survive 40.
Three seasons of Good Times with Mo, and it's going as strong as ever.
Caller of the night is the girl that's banging her best friend's husband.
This is the top downloaded podcast in Philippine history.
And it's not even close. Other shows will copy its style, will mimic its setup, but no one brings it like this.
What's your favorite sexual position?
88. I ate you, you ate me.
Join us as we launch another season, another year. We don't just invite the hard questions, we dare you to come up with one.
Boy, this guy's really weird.
From Los Angeles and Manila, two studios, guest co-hosts, celebrity appearances, and just a whole lot of loving going on. It's the world famous Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 3. And your host, the Philippine genius, Mo Twister.
Podcast time. Here we go. It is a Friday night, 28th of February. Today's the fucking last day of February, right?
Yes, it is.
Oh, hey, look at that voice. If you don't know who that is, well, you're gonna, because she's back after... What has it been? Over a couple months?
Yeah.
I think you were here in December last time. Angelicopter on the program. It is Good Times from all the podcast brought to you by Globe. Our phone number 478-7954. Skype, the Good Times Podcast. You can text us as well. 0927214-1981. I am trying to speak because this is a new background and they have like little pauses, so I have to like kind of go with it. It's like it's podcast.
I love this song.
Great song, man. Fucking Imagine Dragons. Radioactive is the new background music for our intro. Love problems, life problems, sex questions. Call us. You can win Macklemore and Ryan Lewis concert tickets tonight. See?
Yeah, my timing. You gotta do that. Like,
yo, what's up? We can give away these VIP passes to the caller of the night tonight. It's happening on the 16th of March.
Oh, wow.
That's the concert at the Mall of Asia Arena. So tonight, if you are our favorite one, you're going to the motherfucking concert. VIP too, by the way.
When it's VIP, that's like at the very front row or
I don't know if it's front row or there's a VIP section because there's also like a mosh pit. So I don't know if the VIP people are in the mosh pit. I think there might be separate because if you're VIP, why would you want to be like banging around with a bunch of other mosh people pit?
Yeah. Mosh people pit.
I think there's like a VIP section and then
you have
there's like
seating. And then there's
a mosh pit for like the wild fuckers. And I think they're just in the middle or I don't know. It's both the mosh and the VIP are the upper
closest
tier.
Yeah.
Yeah. The upper tier of the tickets. All right. Let's get to it. So, but Chopper, how are you? Fuck. Listen, you have a job now. You work for a radio company. I don't want to say what it is because, you know, we don't want to throw it out there without the permission of them. But you work in the radio industry still. What's the difference between the radio industry here in the U.S. and then say like in the Philippines that you've seen? Because you were with us on Magic.
Without trying
to rip Magic, you know, just kind
of. No. Magic is a lot like the pop stations that we have here. Only we have a different genre called, news talk. So, or talk format where it's more sports talk and news talk radio stations. And they have it in the morning.
On FM.
On FM, that's right.
Okay, yeah, well, that would be different. Because generally, we don't do that stuff.
In our country, we have news talk on the AM, and it's in exactly.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like having your morning show on Magic, but less jokes, more news.
Right.
And you have
and
news
sports.
Reporters.
That's
yeah, but it's still entertaining.
We don't have a sports radio show in the Philippines, do we? I can't recall.
I don't think so.
Boy, there's so many in the U.S., but they fucking love their sports.
Yeah, here ESPN Sports.
Well, that's because you got a lot of major sports. I think that's the Philippines, but it's just, you know, obviously basketball
PBA,
and then basketball and then boxing.
And then ask us, and that's it.
Yeah, well, I mean, but even then, I mean, who would want to listen to the radio 30 minutes of Askal talk? I mean, it's
exactly.
Just, oh, Edge, listen, Edge, love that shit. Let's go to some of these calls and get ready to rock here. We have a lot coming in on a Friday night, payday night. I heard the traffic has just generally been really bad. We were talking about it yesterday, but tonight, more than ever, I'm pretty sure it's legendary. Let's start with Vincent, who is in Bicutan. He's on line 5. Hey, Vincent. What's up?
What's up?
Sup?
How old are you, Vincent? I didn't get that. We don't have the info here.
I'm 17.
Oh, all right. What's up, brother? Thanks for being here. Do me a favor, Pico. Get his volume up a little bit. He sounds a little distant. Or Vince, if you don't mind stepping up to the microphone a little bit closer, please. So, 17-year-old Vincent, you're in Bicutan. How can we help you, sir?
Wait, I'll just adjust this microphone.
You're fine now. Yeah, you're fine, okay. Actually.
Okay. So, me and my girlfriend just broke up a week before Valentine's. So, yeah.
2 weeks
and
ago.
Then, and, oh, really? And this month's Valentine's, I got the new one because, you know, the thing is, actually, the Ferrero, Ferrero flower
chocolate
bouquet gave me. Yeah, exactly. I got it from a friend that won it from you. So I kind of used that on top of that. So, yeah. And then
Ferrero bouquet.
I have a new one now. So.
Oh, okay.
So,
all
you
right.
know, new things, new stuff, new bullshit, you know, new stuff.
I got you, brother.
With.
Yeah, I'm sorry, you're thrilled about your new girlfriend, obviously. And yeah.
The only problem is that, unlike my old girlfriend who kind of, you know, interacts me with a lot, you know, in class, the one I have right now is kind of socially awkward. And when I say that, it's like she talks more with the friends than me, actually, than me. And I just feel really bad because I can just compare the two girls. I mean, my old girlfriend and the new girlfriend. So
that's normal to compare, especially when you went from one girlfriend to the next girlfriend in a span of few days. Like, it's almost natural that you're going to end up comparing because you didn't have, like, a lot of single time. I mean, you said you broke up with your girlfriend the week prior to Valentine's, and then what, a few days later, boom, you already have a new girlfriend, official and, like, fucking exclusive. It's natural that you're going to compare things, and of course they're going to be different because they're different individuals. And your issue with this new girl is that she talks to her friends, she hangs out with other people, she hangs out with a lot of people, I'm assuming, and she doesn't dedicate as much time to you as your last girlfriend did, who probably didn't have a lot of friends to talk to. Is that all?
Yep.
That's your worry here?
I think that's it. The problem is that, you know, since in a relationship, I want to get to know more people. I think I'm missing out an opportunity to do so because, you know, I don't talk to her. It's like an awkward situation. What do I do? I don't know what to do.
Okay, so, let's just summarize one more time. What is your number one problem with the new girl?
I guess she's so socially awkward. So
I don't think that's socially awkward. I don't think it's socially awkward at all. I think she's actually
she's more social.
She's just more social person altogether. She talks to a lot of people, hangs out with a lot of people, has conversations with a lot of people. And if you're the kind of person who doesn't want a girlfriend to do that, to talk to people because, you know, maybe you controlled your last girlfriend a little more and you're feeling you're the one who's socially awkward, or you're the one feeling awkward that, wait a minute, what's this? I have this girl who's actually talking to other people. There are other people that exist in her life outside of me. You know, there are people that way who think that if you're going to be my boyfriend, if you're going to be my girlfriend, all of your attention has to be on me. But it's not going to work well if one person's a more sociable human being who needs a lot of people to, you know, they have a lot of company. And if you're not used to that kind of stuff, you're going to have a clash with her all the time. And this is a common problem in every relationship. When you see the individual, the different kind of personalities involved, the different needs and wants, and it starts to become a problem. You have to either compromise, or more often than not, you have to adjust and deal with it. That, you know, not everyone lives the way you live. They have their own ways. They have their own style of kind of going about their social life. They have their own style about going about their family life. I mean, it's just their individuals are, in fact, that they have their individuals. They have their own sets of like how they carry themselves, how they satisfy whatever fucking need they need, however they interact with other people on a friendship level. Now, if she's like hanging out with dudes and going out to dinner with them or going out to them and not telling you, and then that's a, of course, that's a different story. But if she's just socializing with people instead of socializing with only you, that's not a problem, man. That's not her problem. That's your problem.
Yeah, you should just try to include yourself then. Or if you're really not the sociable type of person and you just want one-on-one or alone time with her,
you're not going to get it.
You're not going to get it because she's
obviously...
So you just
want me to become an Apple dude in this... randomly trash and
oh, you feel excluded. I think that's the issue.
No, I don't think you should have to be Apple. I don't think you, because what I want you to do is not be bothered by it.
Yeah.
You don't have to be like her because as an individual, you're not like her. But you like her. She likes you. She likes you for the quiet dude that you are. You don't have to become a social person like she is. You just have to accept that she is that way.
Don't be bothered by it.
Yeah, and then if you're not bothered by it, then it's not a problem anymore.
But I tried to get over it that, oh no, she talks to other people, it's normal. But how do I get over that it's a normal thing? If you were me, what will you do to kind of...
It's a mature process. The ability to know, to like remove your level of jealousy, to kind of adjust that. It takes a mature person, I think. I'm not saying that you're not mature, but you're 17, and I know with 17 it's very difficult
it's
to kind
hard,
of have a
yeah.
very sound state of mind and say, listen, nothing is going on. She's just this kind of person. I need to accept it, because if I don't, then I'm controlling. And the last thing you want to be, especially early on now, and make it something that's going to grow into some kind of monster when you're in your 20s and 30s, is do not control other people.
Yes.
Because they are not you.
Yes.
They don't think the way you do. They don't fucking behave the way you do. They're not supposed to be you. They are them. You don't control it. You let it be. If you don't like it, don't be with that person. Or
so,
you... Sorry, go ahead.
So what are my options for now? What do I do?
Your options are suck it up, and that's it. Or find a new girlfriend.
Yep. Find an introvert of a girlfriend who will stay indoors with you.
Suck it up or find a new girlfriend who hates people.
There's no way.
Yeah, all right?
It's just really a matter of how much you like this girl. If you really, really like her, and if it's worth it, then just suck it up.
All right?
All right.
All right, Vincent.
I guess.
Rock on, buddy.
Good luck, Vincent.
Thanks, man. Bye-bye.
Right. Thanks.
Thanks. We got a lot of calls coming in. 478-7954. Skype the Good Times Podcast. You can text us 0927-214-1981. Let's go to line 3 and talk to Gene. Hi, Gene. Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hey, Gene. How are you?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Chopper.
Hi.
What's going on?
Okay. I have this problem. Office scenario.
Right.
We're in a small office lang. And then there's someone... high position, nagpa-power trip sa akin. In small ways, pero obvious naman, ganun.
Like, give me the worst one or the most recent one.
Example.
The most recent one, pagpapasok siya sa room namin, 10 people on the room, lahat babati niya isa-isa, hi name, ganyan. Except me. Na alam naman
and
niya
she's a girl.
Girl yun, girl.
Of course, babae.
Girl.
Yeah.
Only
super
girls
simple
do
lang,
that.
Pero nakakainis.
Nakakainis nga.
Yeah, well.
With all smells pa niya babatiin lahat. Pero alam naman niya nandun ako.
Yeah,
and then,
sucks. Now, is she your immediate... is she your immediate superior?
You report directly to?
Hindi.
Ah, okay. Well, then,
so,
okay.
So, parang, ang hint ko is, nagkakaroon siya ng jealousy kasi I work directly with the boss. I report directly sa boss.
Possibly.
And yung boss is confident naman sa skills ko. So parang ayaw niya yung ganun.
Ayaw ng boss. So wait, this has been brought up. Okay, I'm sorry. All right. So and then
hindi siya ganun ka close dun sa boss, ganun.
Sige. And then on a professional level, you said she did one more thing?
Ayun, yung ganun, yung work-wise.
Okay.
Kung ano-ano yung silip niya. Eh samantalang yung yung boss ko mismo, wala naman nire-reklamo.
Yeah.
Yung ganun. So, ano yung pwede kong magawa para makaganti naman ng konting inis sa kanya?
Have lunch with your boss or something, like annoy her even more.
Yeah, there's several ways. I mean, Chopper, I answer that last one. Which one? How you want to attack this? And you're a girl, by the way, and you're villainous gender.
No, but I experienced this also before in my corporate job in Manila, and because I report directly to the boss, and it was a marketing department, and there was another marketing department division, pero hiwalay na division. So, I just make sure you cover your ass, do your job always, get everything done. Walang masusumbat sa'yo yung girl na, you didn't do this, you didn't do that, or you made a mistake. So always.
Okay, but let's assume she knows that because that's what she's doing now. Okay. Her question is, paano ba mag gumante?
To gumante.
Yeah. there's gante the right way, then there's gante the wrong way. The right way being what Chopper said.
The right way is, be really good.
Be really good at your job. Make sure the boss always understands that, sees you, acknowledges your ability and stuff like that. And then there's the masamang gante, which is the sabotage gante, which is a lot of fun, but could get you fucking fired.
Yeah, you don't want to do that because
I don't want to say you don't want to do that. I'm just saying you better think.
But I don't
I know you want to. Yep. Yeah, that's the thing. I know, because I would want to do it too. I would likely do it as well.
Yeah, but there's no like big reason for her to do so, to risk her job right now. It's not worth it right now, di ba?
Yeah.
Because if you get caught, wala naman masyadong malaking ginagawa sa yun, that other girl, right? It's not worth it to risk your job yet. Your boss likes you. You get the job done. You might be up for a promotion end of the year. You don't know. And then you're going to risk it for what? Because she didn't say hello to you this morning? If she fucks you up big time, then fuck her up big time. But for now, it's eating her alive that every day she sees you, the new girl, and the boss likes you. So just feed off of that. Have lunch with the boss or make sure that every time.
That invites a whole bunch of other problems when you start having lunch with the boss and stuff like that. I mean, you know, then.
No, in the office. In the office, sometimes, like, I don't know if your boss eats out or in the office. Like, I remember before my boss would have lunch. The conference room in the office, and every now and then, yung mga favorites niya, invite niya to join for lunch. Like, because you did a good job. Okay, so have lunch with us, sit in with us, or, you know, yung mga perks na ganun, then you get to sit with the boss and the boss's friends, or you're introduced to the other CEOs of the company because you did a great job. Yung ganun, just spite her.
And does the boss like her? Like, meaning he's happy with her performance as well?
I guess, kasi head din naman siya ng isa pang ng 2 departments. So, yun na nga yung irony doon.
I would make it a personal challenge more than anything than to you to fucking do so well this year that you can kind of catch up. And I think it's possible. I mean, if the boss is like you and you work hard and you sound really smart anyway, you sound like a good person, you know, just try not to let it bother you, because you know how we make fun of that, this is girl behavior, the girl to not say hi to you, but to say hi to everyone else. It's also a girl thing to let it bother you.
Yes.
Stop being girls. And when I say girls, I'm not like making fun of the gender, but you know, that little chick thing that you guys do. And there's guy things also. I mean, I'm not putting down the entire gender, but orientation or anything like that, but it's more.
In this case.
Whatever the girl thing that is, which is to piss you off and to make you angry and to harass you and to make you jealous, it's also a very girl thing to be affected by it. So remove that part from you. Don't be affected by it, and then be hungry. Be hungry to do well.
Be motivated.
Yeah, silently in the back of the dungeons of your mind, go fuck you, bitch, every time you do something really good.
Okay.
Just don't let it affect you, though, and make it more of a competition than a revenge plot.
Yeah, because if... don't let it get to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
It'll stop. She'll get tired of it. She'll get sick and tired of it. Or another girl is gonna come along. Or she's.
I don't think she's gonna get tired of it. Mayabang yun eh. Ganyan talaga pag mayabang.
Or hindi magiging. Just, you know, or she'll realize that you're not a threat. Is your boss a guy?
Yes.
Oh, that's why.
Oh wait, who's prettier, you or her?
Me.
That's right.
What's your Twitter?
Already, baby.
What's your Twitter?
You win already, Gene. You win already.
Uh-oh. Panalo ka na.
Just work hard. You're gonna
There are rumors. I just confirmed 2. Pero mga 5 employees na yung umalis ng dahil sa attitude niya na ganyan.
Then don't leave. Yeah, don't
well,
leave.
Well, maybe you can, you know, maybe you can find a way to
That's
get these
I'm
people
doing.
All
I'm,
together,
I'm,
you know,
kasi
write
I'll,
a group.
I'll make her happier pa pag umalis ako, di ba?
Yeah,
yeah,
no, do
yeah,
no,
don't.
No, no,
she
no,
wants
no,
you
no,
to
no,
leave.
No. This is a job. You're not quitting a job because of that fucking person.
Yeah.
No. I'm talking about getting the other guys put together, maybe doing once or for mass email from all of these 5 to the boss, telling him, hey, listen, just to want you to know, I spoke to everyone else, or on behalf of all everyone else, there's 5 of us here that left because she's a bitch. That's a good revenge. You know, talking them into
it.
Saying, yeah, talking them into saying, hey, the 5 of us, we just want you to know that it's not, we didn't quit for any other reason but for that fucking whore right there. And, you know,
yeah.
Okay.
But that whore might be sleeping with the boss. You don't know.
No, just
so.
but hey, in the end, money's money, man. Fuck, man. I don't care how much pussy you're getting from that fucking girl, and you're hotter, by the way. It's the bottom line is the bottom line. Like you could be really pretty, kung mayabang ka, and they'll find a way to get your ass out of there. So yeah. I think that a group email would be kind of cool. Thanks for the call, love. Appreciate it. Have a good one. Bye bye, Gene.
Okay, bye bye.
Let's go to. We have time for one more here. Let's go to one more because we have so many calls. I want to make sure, see if we can squeeze in 3. Dom, you're 17. Hi, Dom. You're on line 5.
Hey, good evening, guys.
Good evening, Dom. You're from Malabang. How can we help you?
So, there. I study in a well-known school in Malabang, and then.
Ah, Zabel. Nice.
My
Does it
teacher,
rhyme with Zabel? Dom.
Yeah.
It rhymes with Zobel.
Yes.
Dumb. Yeah, okay. All right, what's up? Your teacher's what?
So, yeah, my teacher is flirting, like, with me and my friends. So, like, flirting, like, touching us. And then, like...
Touching?
You know, like, getting close and stuff.
She's a girl?
It's kinda, yeah, she's a girl.
Cool.
It's kind of weird, but she's like, you know what a MILF is, right?
Yeah, she's a male. So she is kind of hot. How old is she? Like 30s?
Like 30s to like 40s, something like that.
Oh, so she's like...
Late 30s, man, okay.
She's like the latter MILF. She's like almost cougar.
Almost cougar passing MILF.
Yeah, she's well beyond like hanging on to dear MILF life. Already just about footsteps or
my ladder, yeah, pala yan.
Her toes are inside the Freddy Cougar fucking pool
dipping
already.
It, yeah.
Dipping it in. Alright. So she's kinda like a cougar. Alright. Alright, Dom. So yeah, she's flirting with you, so, touching you guys? Where is she touching you?
What's a baby cougar?
What?
29. Yeah. What okay, so she's
touching you.
She's touching you guys?
Yeah, she's
How?
Touching us.
Like
caressing you, like the shoulders, going on.
Like on your balls?
Like flirting touch.
Ah, okay, so mga shoulder, arm. May dinadrag niya yung arm niya sa mga arms mo. Okay, alright, yeah, and
so,
then?
Yeah, so, a while ago, she like, went to me and said, you wanna go to the car? So I was like, I have to go somewhere. Then she said, okay, it's whenever you want to go to the car. Just tell me.
To so do like, what?
Well, I need a dick.
That's not me.
So, okay. So when she said car, did she say why you wanted to go to the car? Did she say, you want to go to the car? May tint ako.
Or tapos may wink? Yeah, you kumikin that? Or like...
What's in the car?
She was like...
I know.
She was like, cool. She was like, from like my shoulder, she held it, and then going down to my wrist, she was like, "Wanna go to the car?" And I was like, "No, I'm sorry, I need to go somewhere."
Nice.
Dom, pogi ka ba, Dom?
Yeah.
Ano Twitter mo?
Yeah. So Dom, what's the question, buddy?
So yeah, because I asked my friends, because when we went to the gym, I told my friends the story, and they said. Sabi niya, sabi ng friend ko, ay puta, nice one gyan. And then my other said, kadiri ka bro. So, I don't know what to do. Sabi niya,
hindi mo alam kung nice one talaga or ay puta.
Are you virgin?
Sabi ng my friend said, bro, gawin mo na for experience lang. Then my other friend said, "Oh, bro, baka meron ng STD yan. I don't know what to do."
God, who's the pussy who brings in the STD? Oh, Jesus, come on. Okay, Dom, are you a virgin?
No.
Okay.
But then, are you sure?
You've had a lot of sex in your life, different girls and all that.
Not just twice, only.
Twice. Okay. What do you want to do about it, Dom? I just want to pick your brain a little bit before we tell you what we think you should do.
So this was this morning. She asked you to go to the car with her. Okay.
What do you want to do about
school.
It?
After school.
Mm-mm.
Yeah. What do you want to do about it? What's your gut tell you? What's your first initial kind of instinct to do?
I just want to slap her in the face and say no. But then it's like this thing inside me want to do it. It is a MILF, you know.
Yeah.
It is a MILF. It talaga.
Sayang din yun, di ba?
You see how he refers to her as an object? It is a MILF.
Well, why would you want to slap her in the face, though, to be honest? I mean, why would you want to slap her in the face?
She's like, if she like, you know, she's like late 30s or 40s, at least she can get like a decent guy, like older. But then she's going for younger guys.
So those religion classes are really kicking. What class? I can't say what class she teaches. You might get in trouble. All right. All right. What to do? Here we go.
Ay, nako. Whatever you do, you have to get it recorded just in case.
Pico, get over here.
Mm-hmm. Pico.
Oh my, it never happened to me in high school.
Yeah, this never fucking happened to me either. How say you, Pico? What are we gonna do here?
You went to Bulacan school.
The nuns never did. They never did this to me, so I don't know what to do.
How old is he again?
He's 17. He's 17 years old.
I do it.
Her. You do it since you're 17.
Sorry, Chopper. Her. Yeah.
That doesn't mean anything.
Why would you do it?
Why would you do it, Pico?
Sayang yun eh.
Sayang? I don't know.
If you do it, you tell your friends. You do it? Your classmates?
No, I don't do that. Yeah.
Yeah, well, no, that's bullshit. When you're 17, I'm serious. You're telling your 17. Classmates. That's fuck that shit. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I slept with her.
17, yeah.
Okay, here's the deal. Dom, it's scandalous. You understand that, right? It's scandalous, meaning you're a minor, some sort. To an extent, you're a minor. When are you turning 18, buddy?
Next year, January.
Tagal pa.
You can't let her wait. Uh-oh. All right. Obviously, it's scandalous. Teacher-student relationships are always scandalous, frowned upon, bad ethics. You're less than 18, but I think the age for consensual sex in the country is 16 or 14 or
Freddy.
Yeah, I don't know. Somebody, if we ask fucking Freddie what it is. Is she married?
Yeah. She has...
my goodness.
You have that angle. Yeah, Dom, two kids. Yeah, let's not do it, bud.
With two kids? Yeah, gosh. Not, the son, by the way, goes to the same school.
Yeah, I know. Next thing you're fucking classmates with him and shit. And let's not do this.
No, don't do it.
You know, the reason why I'm not screaming don't do it right away, because, and as we should, though, I mean, as people that look up, you know, people look up to us, Chopper, and you know, we do an advice show, the responsible thing for us to do is say stay away. This is really... That she's a criminal. She is a bad teacher. She's a bad person. She's an abuser. Yeah, she abuses her power and all of these things. That's what we would say if it was a male teacher and a female student.
That's right. But this is a female.
When you flip it around, you start getting into bucket list levels. Like the first one, if it's a guy teacher and a female, it's like, oh my god, molester, abuse,
rape.
Fucking, you know, call the NBI. When it's the other way around, it's about a high five, bucket list, all of these things. I mean, it's just you see the huge dynamic change when it comes to whether it's going to be a guy or a girl. Sorry, you were going to add something, Dom?
Yeah, I heard the rumor. Like, do you guys watch the U-Up games?
No, we don't. We happen to be in the U.S. right now, so we don't get to watch. But why? She banged some of the players?
Yeah. The old person from LaSalle, he came from Nobel. Then they banged. Yeah, nice. In the car.
Yeah.
Ew, baka may STD sa talaga sa car. Kung sino-sino na pala nandun.
Daming stain dyan sa upholstery. All right, do me a favor, bud. Don't do it. It's just, it's a little too scandalous. If I were you, maybe I would save any kind of evidence that she was giving some sort of like advances, text messages, emails, or anything like that, just in case this goes to shit. But if I were you, just tell her, listen, ma'am, birthday ko next January. So birthday ko na lang, you know, just parang a big 18th birthday. You know, just kind of delay the entire thing. So
but
you
don't, yeah.
Well, because I don't want her to take it out on you by giving you bad grades and all of that. If you start, say, slapping her in the face or calling her fucking, you know, get yourself a real guy, then you're going to fucking struggle with your grades. And then I don't know if you want to tell the principal, but I would...
Save it for later.
Yeah.
Save it for later if you have evidence.
Come on, dude. You're a dude. You're not 15. You're 17. I mean, there's a big difference. But at the same time, you might want to tell the principal, because what if she's doing these sexual advances to the 14-year-olds and to the 13-year-olds? We don't really know. So it's a very difficult... It's a very difficult thing. I'd say collect some evidence. Maybe do a little research. See if there's any other students that this is happening to. Try to get together, talk about it, and then make a better judgment on what to do then. I'm supposed to tell you to report it because that's the right thing to do. Report it to the principal, to the staff, and whatever. But at the same time, realistically...
If it happened to Pico and Mo, they're going to go for it.
No, I'm not going for it. 40s? If it was me, I would just kind of say, hey, how about next year na lang when it's my birthday?
When 41 ka na.
Yeah, I mean, you know, something like that. You're married. You know, come up, I really like you, but you're married. I'm scared. I'm only 7. How am I going to defend myself when your husband comes after me? You can come up with nice ways to reject her that won't make your grades suffer, that will kind of, you'll give her a little bit of hope, but ultimately you're not making any moves. You're just delaying the process until you get out of school. Okay?
All right. All right.
That's what I would do. Thanks for the call, man. Appreciate it, Dom.
Thank you, guys. Have a good
Bye-bye.
Evening.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Jesus.
Teachers. Come on. But Zabel is not an all-boys school, right?
No, it's co-ed.
Co-ed.
Well, she's a female teacher. She's not going to fucking flirt with a female
No, I mean,
student.
I'm just saying, like, baka sobrang daming boys and they'll overwhelm you. No, but there are girls there.
No, she's just, maybe that's her thing, man.
Yeah.
But this is not a wild question. We get this question all the time.
I know.
But, well, you know, it's wild when, you know, these girls call in. They're 15, they're 14, and they have this scenario.
Yeah.
The teacher's like fucking 35, 40, 50. Then we're like, oh, my God. I mean, such a change in our mood. When it's a 17-year-old dude with a teacher who's banged a few students already, it's kind of her MO. And
yes.
The cars always park there like a little fucking mobile motel by the thing. It's just, you know.
Oh,
I don't know, man.
God.
When you're 17 and you're a dude, it's so different. But I feel so guilty by telling him not to report it. Like, I feel guilty to even kind of let it drag on.
Yeah, well, he should get evidence. For me, it's like,
the evidence is obviously the first. I mean, especially if you listen to the show, you know that evidence is number one, man. I don't give a fuck what you get involved in. Evidence is number one. But what I'm saying is that the whole...
Drag it on until he turns 18.
Yeah, you know, it's irresponsible for us to say not to report it. But it's realistically, it's a guy. I mean, you got Pico here. Pico, you're what? You're 22, Pico? You still would be banging this girl at 17 if you could, man.
He would still be banging that girl now.
Oh, no, she's married. I didn't know she was married.
And you're only worried about that because the husband will come after you with a gun.
Yeah. But if she
that's all. There's no
but if you
moral...
can defend yourself.
Yeah,
you...
if she, there's no moral aspect to it.
No,
I don't want to destroy a marriage.
No,
or be a
that, yeah, that's it. Yeah, there. That too.
Yeah, that one too. Yeah, count that in.
Yeah.
Friday night with Angelicopter. You can follow her on Twitter at The Angelicopter. It's Good Times to Know. The podcast brought to you by Globe. Our phone number 478-7954. You can Skype us as well. The Good Times podcast. Text 0927-214-1981 to get yourself on the program. Got a lot of calls tonight, so let's get to them after this commercial break. Don't go away.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
Agent CT, what's your status?
Everything looks great, HQ. CDCP looks fine.
From
remember, your powers come from the signal feeds from cell towers, so make sure you stay within reach.
I'll be fine, HQ. There are more than 7,000 globe cell sites scattered across country. See? I see one right there.
What's the problem over there? I'll go check it out.
Be careful, Agent CT. If you need any assistance...
HQ.
Agent.
HQ, do you read me?
Respond, Agent CT. Do you copy? What's your status?
Do you copy?
Your status.
HQ! Where am I? There seems to be no signal tower in this village. My signal senses are tingling. What to do? What to do? Aha! I know Agent CT! Oh yeah, I forgot. I don't have powers here. Normal citizen!
Normal citizen!
Secure permission.
Secure permission!
To the Homeowners Association meeting.
Homeowners Association Office.
Excuse me.
Okay, on to other issues. Cell phone signals. We're here to answer questions.
Oh, great. Just the proper form. Let's go.
We finalized today. Any more concerns? Yes.
Good afternoon, all. On cell sites, we need to set up a cell site within this village. Your laptops, your cell phones, your tablets, they feed on signal for them to work. You see, it does not even have to look like a cell site. It just has to look like it belongs.
But what about the health risks?
Yeah, fear not. Several studies show that the radio frequency signals used by these cell sites do not affect your health. It's just like the frequency used by baby monitors, AM and FM radios, your Wi-Fi. Completely harmless. Think about
it. That's exactly what we need.
Without wireless communication, how will you stay updated? How will you talk to your loved ones who are abroad?
Yeah.
How will you remind your kids to take care and to come home early?
That's right. We need a cell site.
No, thank you, random citizen.
I want a cell site right now!
I agree!
Super Agent CT! See? True power lies within each citizen. Signal connects us. Together, we will make more villages a more comfortable place to live in. I guess my mission here is done.
Oh, great. We thought we lost you, Agent CT.
That's Super Agent CT now!
Friend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the program here, Friday night, it is Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Season 3, brought to you by Globe. Boy, three. You know, Chopper, I know we're saying this every single day. It's just because I want to wow the people who are here on the show. 30, okay. 35 million downloads now.
Wow, for just the season 3
now? No. I mean, total. 30. Season 3 did 15 million. Season 2 did 15 million.
Oh, season 2. We're on season 3 now. Yeah. Nice. Wild, huh? Millions. I don't think anyone else does that in the Philippines.
You know, I said, hey guys, 35 million downloads. Bong Review said, what? Did I hear 35 million? Starts texting me.
Sina?
Just kidding, the joke. It's a pork barrel joke.
Oh, 35 million.
35 million downloads is Bong Revilla and really is texting me. They go, what? Did somebody say 35 million?
Corny. Oh my gosh, a little so too
fuck
slow.
Fuck you. That's a great joke. It's a great political joke. I'm tweeting that bitch. Before Showbiz Bro
before
in the background.
Before Mark White steals it.
Showbiz Bro's here, by the way, in the background there, hanging out with us. Bro.
Nagpaalam ka ba sa asawa mo?
No, bro's, pare. Bro's thing. Yeah, bro has... Ito talaga mayabang si bro. Kasi, and I'll say this on the radio come Monday.
Why?
So bro is one of these guys na very hardcore proud to be from the north. You know, like me. You know, like, you know, there's, okay, fine, I'm successful and all of this stuff. But man, through and through to the core, I'm fucking hashtag north all the way. Right?
Okay.
And then you have like Susie who's on the show, fucking hashtag south, hardcore social, core, fucking all that shit. Bro and I get along because he's not just from the fucking north. He's from the shit north. Malapon. You know?
Malapon talaga.
Guess where this asshole moved? He moved to the fort. This week.
How dare you?
Sell out.
Hanep.
Pakyu.
Gusto niya maging hashtag south?
Ang yabang mo.
You're si Katlay.
Hindi pa nga south yun. Makati pa.
Porket naging 11,000 followers mo. He left the hard.
Excuse me, 11,600.
Yeah, 11,600.
My accent.
He left the war zone that is Malabon Navotas to go to the fort.
Malabon is just too massa for me now.
Malabon is too massa for you.
It's too...
smells fishy.
Ew, and you use the word massa pa? Ew.
Oh,
why would you do that? God, grabe.
Kasi paglabas ko doon, fishport eh.
Fishport?
Main product, patis. Hi, I'm from Malabon. Buy our patis, di ba?
Hindi kasi endorsements daw naman nakukuha niya.
So wait, time out. Did you change your bio on Twitter already? Instead of location, Malabon, location, the fort.
Hindi pa.
Ay, putang ina, kailangan.
Kailangan, ay, the fort. Huwag tagiga.
Ikaw ang pinakaraming followers ng Twitter sa Malabon, sa Malabon area.
Sa Malabon, ako ang tama yan.
Putang ina, guaranteed yun. Walang artista dyan sa Malabon, ikaw lang.
Ay, di ba may bilang?
I represent, di ba?
Ay, shit.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, change your Twitter account to name Malabon's Finest. 11,000.
I'll do that.
Wait, by the way, these are all jokes that we have to rewrite and use for the radio on Monday as if we've never thought of it. So
make sure to write all of this down.
Oh, puta, I'm going to go back to the background. We got calls to take, you fucker. All right.
No, busa na.
You can follow him on Twitter, by the way, at ShowbizBro. 11,600 followers from Malabon. Who would have thought? Rags
from
to riches.
From Pekoy, nalis ko na yung 899.
I was gonna say, wala na yung 899.
Di na kailangan, eh.
No,
di na
exclusivity.
Ng support.
Yeah. I gave them a year to give me a contract. They did not
walang
contact
binigay.
Me, diba?
Nako.
So it's all fair game
talaga.
Now. I'm calling RX. Any station?
Para siyang ano to, yung mga traffic report, lahat ng station, same person, di ba? Pero showbiz report.
That's good, though.
Yeah, that's what Pia Guanyo used to do, man. She used to do the traffic report nilang sa atin, RT, K-Light, lahat. All right. Makoy, thanks for being here, man. We appreciate it. And I know that all of a sudden, you can come to the studio more often because we're in Rockwell and you're in the fort na. So,
it's like, bababa lang ako ng bahay.
Yeah.
Wow, yeah. You're like neighbors with Georgina and Borgie. Yeah,
everyone's in their get-up and then I'm just in my pambahay.
Yeah, because hey, you live here in the fort.
Yeah, you're local. You know, it's not a big deal.
Like, si Makoy, kumakain sa mamu, nakachinelas ang, kasi hindi na may...
Wala na ba kayong bago? Nakain ko na lahat yan eh.
How come you're not this funny when we're writing the jokes?
Pare, we write the jokes 3 a.m. in the morning.
Palitan niyo yung meeting niyo.
Di ba nga ikaw na yung bagong Jesus ko, di ba? Bago ako mag-pray, ikaw yung kausap ko eh. Mo, just woke up.
Yeah, good morning. Yung asawa pa niya nagsusnore sa background.
Hindi ka pa nag-good morning sa misis mo. Nakapag-good morning ka na kay mo.
Putangin na mo, huwag ka maingay. Natutulog pa ang misis ko.
All right, we gotta go. We have calls. Get out of here. Bye-bye. Okay. Let's go to Meg, who is in Canada. Meg, you're 16 years old. Canada, line 5. Hi, Meg.
Hi.
What's going on, love? Where in Canada are Hello? You? That's a fairly large country.
Toronto.
Nice. Beautiful city, man. Fucking love Toronto.
Yeah.
You've been a Toronto chopper, right?
Yes.
Gorgeous. It's really I'm going to be in Toronto. Well, no, not next year. Next year, that's New York for the All-Star Game. The year after, the NBA All-Star Game is going to be in Toronto. Make sure that... if I haven't insulted you or anything yet on Twitter, make sure that you and I hang out. Like, I want to make sure I keep in touch. We have so many Toronto callers here from the podcast
you
that I want to do.
You did your show from there also.
Yeah, I did the show from Toronto before. So I want to make sure next time we get there, like all the podcast callers that call from Toronto, we all kind of meet up and
It's your friend's Thai restaurant.
Yeah, that's right. All right. So anyway, let's get to your question. What's going on, Meg? What happened?
Okay. So when you're an immigrant and... Yes. People here are going to call you a fob.
Yeah.
And
fob is
how do you deal with it?
It's fresh off the boat, meaning parang like kakarating lang and it came from a fucking refugee raft or something into their country.
Really?
Yeah. And you know, as you know, Toronto... Well, I mean, it's kind of weird because Toronto is more of any major city.
It's multicultural.
Yeah, of any major city in Canada, that's the one. I mean, you've got a huge Somali population there. You've got a huge Chinese population. You've got a lot of... You got a lot of different kinds there, but when you're 16 and you're in school, kids are still racist.
Oh, okay. So there's a negative connotation to the fob talaga.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, being a fob is like it's one of the bigger insults you can throw somebody. Anyway, whatever. What's up?
Pardon?
Yeah. So is that your problem?
Oh, yeah. So how do you deal with it?
How old are you again?
She's 16 though. Oh. Was this high school?
Yeah.
All right. Well, what's the worst thing they say?
I remember when meron kaming gagawing for a school activity and it's a group activity, and they said that they don't want to be paired with the fob. Yun.
God, how awful.
Parang hurt ganun.
Are these white kids that are telling you this, or even Filipinos?
No, they're Filipinos.
It's what?
Oh yeah, yeah. There's a big division. It's not just in Toronto. It's also in the U.S. When you're fresh off the boat Filipino and then you're born American na Pinoy, sobrang yabang yun.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. It's awful.
I didn't know that.
And then they don't speak Tagalog either. They think like if you speak Tagalog, it's kind of I don't know. It's bad if you speak Filipino. It's one of these things. Yeah. So these guys don't know these things. Are there any other fucking fobs that you can befriend?
Join the fob group.
Yeah, are you the only one? Usually what I saw growing up is the fobs stuck together as like it was some sort of prison. And the Amboys and stuff like that did their own thing. And then some of the Amboys would kind of bleed over into the fobs because there are quite a few Amboys who think being from the Philippines is actually really cool. It's like motherland. You know, these are the kind of Amboys that
the patriotic type.
You know, they tattoo the flag on their body and whatnot. So, are there a lot of other fobs there, or are you the only one?
No, I'm the only one.
Oh shit! You're fucking singled out. Yeah, that's gonna be tough. You know,
go to a different school.
Yeah, at this point, I really don't know what to tell you except. You just power through it. Your English is excellent. Your English is much better than most fobs.
Thank you.
So it's not like you're completely, isolated. You do carry yourself well. Your vocabulary is fine. You just your accent is ever so slight also. I mean, it's not the heavy fob accent that, when you come from, say, like the province, say you say in Eastern Samar or something like that, and you end up going to Canada, it's really so obvious. You know, you got the P's and the F's and all of these things. Not saying Samar has but you get what I mean. There's a heavy accent in some of the Visayan areas, and when they go to these major cities, they're going to get picked on. You seem like a Manila girl, so you're not so obvious fob, and I think you can kind of get away with that. If people call you fob, just say, hey, I don't want to be paired up with the fob. And then you just, I don't know, you come back with a nice witty retort. Something like, let's see, if I was a fob and
what would you
I'm
say?
In class and someone says, hey,
group yourselves into three. I don't want to group yourself with your fobs.
And I go, then I'll say something like, then how about the two or three TNT uncles that you have living in your house? Like, why are they there, you know? I mean, I would come up with something like that. Because most Pinoy families have a TNT relative living with them anyway. So you can kind of exploit that. Like, hey, at least I'm here legally because I'm an immigrant compared to your... And then you could say sister, brother, mom, or whatever who is kind of TNTing it there. If you have a brother who can kind of go up to him and beat the shit out of him, I could suggest that as well.
Okay.
Yeah, like, yeah, we're fob, but in fob, we do it like this, and you stab him.
I know, right?
We have knives in our country.
You'll be badass. Yeah, they'll stay away from you.
Kind of works out well for you. But what I do is stick around. Hang out with people who are not from Toronto initially. Hang out with those guys. Okay. And whether it be from the Philippines, from Somalia, from all of these other, there's a common denominator there. You're all new. So find them. You don't always have to just hang out with Filipinos. And then you'll see. It'll
get better. This is just the...
And do me a favor. If they're still picking on you 2 years from now when I get there, Chopper, why don't you come with me? Why don't we all go over there, pay those guys a visit, and I'll kind of show them what the difference between fob and real shit is. Okay?
We'll bring Mahoy pare.
Yeah, I'll make sure to humiliate them thoroughly in
front
of them. And then if you're a listener of this program and you are... You're Filipino, you listen to this podcast, you grew up in Toronto, you grew up in Vancouver, you grew up in New York, Chicago, wherever, I don't give a fuck, San Francisco, and you see this going on, you got to stand up for these people who are work from the Philippines and coming in. It's a tough thing. The reason why I say this, and the reason why, like, I always ask Pinoys, even in the Philippines, to not be tough on foreigners, to Koreans, to fucking Indians and all of that stuff is... There is an equivalent in your family somewhere in another country that's going through the same exact thing.
Exactly, yeah.
And the moment you start picking on one of your own, these people who are picking on you at school, they have relatives in Italy, they have relatives in England, they have relatives in Australia, in Saudi, in Dubai, in all of these other places that are getting picked on as well. That's the thing about being Pinoy. We all have someone that's abroad trying for either a better life, a new life, a different life, and they're getting picked on by that fucking a group of people in that area. So if you're the kind of guy that says, daming Koreano dito sa Manila, putang ina, guess what? You have a tita, you have an uncle, you have a cousin, you might have a sibling, you might have a father or mother that's busting their ass in Kuwait and they're getting fucking ridiculed as well.
And people
so
are saying,
before you open your mouth, you better check yourself because I fucking guarantee you have someone in your family that's going through the same exact bullshit that you're going through. And that is
you're gonna
wrong. And if you have a problem with that, you call me and watch me. I will dismantle your ass solid. There's nothing you can say that is better than what I'm going to tell you. I fucking dare you. So those kids, fuck them. Hang out with the ones, the thing. And look for some Horn of Africa motherfuckers. You know, guys who are like, will fucking stand up for you.
From Djibouti or
something. Yeah, fucking stab a motherfucker. Yeah. All right? All right.
Okay.
Good stuff.
Thank you.
Come on, Meg. Rock on, baby.
Imagine if her friends are like from Somalia and then they're walking outside of school. Makasalubong nila yung mga white boys tayo na
you want us to Captain Phillips your shit?
That's right. I'm the captain now.
Let's go to line three and talk to Sans, who's 26 in Pasig.
Sans.
Hi, Sans.
Hi, guys. Good evening from Manila.
Yeah, sorry. Hello. Ew.
Ew, Manila.
We have our own fob. Our little fob conflict in the Philippines is all about socioeconomic status. Like, remember when I was saying, hey, you know what's a great way to sabotage a really social place like a 71 Gramercy is go ahead and pay fucking Jejemons to go to that place. That's what I would like if I was. And the rich people look down. Our rich people look down so much on the poor in Manila or in our country. That's our divide. That's why. Social economic divide. So I was saying this on the radio. McCoy, was this on the radio? Get your ass back over here.
No, that's why they keep opening up new clubs. Kasi when
the Jejemons grab it.
It's like, oi, dun pumupunta sina.
Was this on the radio or was this on the podcast where I did this whole 71 Gramercy social climbing so far kind of bullshit?
Radio.
That's radio. So, okay, I'll say it on the podcast here. If I was, Sans, we'll get to your question in a little sec. If I was a competing club, right? I would, instead of invest in marketing, invest in advertising, which can be in the millions, this is what I would do. I would rent out, and let's just say 71 Gramercy, because that seems to be like the new hip place I see on Twitter. I would rent out that venue for a private corporate thing, because that's what they do. They make money from that. So that's going to cost me. How much is a corporate place going to cost me, Chopper?
Well,
rent that out for one night.
Rent? No, this is a half of it.
But no. I'll take the whole thing one night.
Shit. So you go to 300.
300,000. That's nothing for what you're going to spend in advertising. 300,000 pesos. I'm going to go up to 71 Gramercy. Can I rent your thing for an event? And then what kind of event? Oh, awards night for our company. Sure. Then I would invite the Jejemons from north to south. From north to mid-north. Everybody, get over here and mag-selfie kayo, mag-picture, mag-Instagram the shit out of this place. And then all of a sudden, it becomes badoy. You only spend 300,000. You have nothing. That place goes to shit. Because the rich are so protective of the image that the poor cannot hang out in our areas.
Oh, when they start
the moment the Jejemons hang out here, they're opening our business crashes.
Yeah, they open
up a
new 100, one.
100 per head for people from Malabon, di ba?
Of course, yung mga kaibigan, yung mga 11,000 followers ni Makoy, pupunta dyan. You can do all
organize
of those
it
things.
For you.
Yeah.
Open bar pa.
If you are a competing bar or club, if you want to destroy another club, it's not what you invest in your place. It's what you invest in telling people to go to that place. And guess what? Here's the thing. The rich don't want the poor to go there, but they can't deny the poor to go there. Because the worst thing to do is say, oh, you're not allowed inside our place. Yeah. Well, why? I have money. Give the Jejemons money to spend. I have money. I can go in there. The moment that they don't allow you, boom, Facebook article, Facebook scandal. Na oy hindi pro Pinoy ang club na yan and all of that stuff. They're what is it called? This discriminatory to their own kind. That's even worse. So you're really at a win-win situation here. You either A, infiltrate the club by telling Jejemons to go and giving them money to spend at the club. B, fucking rent the place
the
out and Instagram the fucking hell out of that place. Every floor of the elevator. Uy, nasa elevator. Nasa floor 67 na tayo. Malapit nasa 71. Or C, go there, get denied at the door because you're Jeje, and then have some sort of article or scandal come out saying these people don't allow you there. Boom. That fucking place is done. Done, I say. And all it cost you was $500,000. That's a small price to pay.
Yeah, but the thing is, the competition, they're all the same group. There's no competition.
That's why you just jump from one place to another. You're going to drive the rich all to Timog.
Tapos si Makoy, bad trip si Makoy. Lumipat-lipat pa ako sa Fort.
Nandiyan na ako sa Fort. Putang yan, babalik na ako sa Morato.
Nauso sa iba.
Babalik na naman ako sa QC.
Lahat ng my hip places, Morato, BF.
Fairview.
Fairview, mga restaurant dyan.
SMF. My
All
God.
Right. Sans. Sorry, love. You're 26. How can we help you, baby?
It's okay. How are you guys? Thank you for taking my call.
Oh, well, thank you for having us. What can we do? Is it you have a problem?
Okay. So basically, here's my issue. I'm seeing a married guy, but he already separated and he's a pilot and he's really lovely. But
he really loves you?
One issue with him.
Uh-huh. Wait, time out. He's a pilot, he's married, but he's separated he really loves you?
And I mean he's lovely. I mean
okay. He's awesome.
He's divine and I love him.
Okay.
And okay. Then? But I have an issue because, okay, the reason he separated from the wife is because apparently the wife cannot come. Like, even though he's fucking his brains
divine?
Out, or her brains out, apparently frigid yung wife. So,
and he told you
sa akin, okay naman siya. Kaya lang parang nawi-weirdohan lang ako. Kasi parang he wants to eat me all the time and he requires me to squirt all the time.
He's such a great guy. He's like
he's so divine.
Best.
I love him.
He left his wife and children because she couldn't come, and he wants me to piss children. On him every single time. He wants me to urinate on him.
Marriage, no
children. Not urine.
Because the wife refuses to have sex with him.
That's awesome. Fucking love this guy.
And then,
okay, so what's
you
your
sure
issue? What are, is your issue? His past or the present? What's the issue?
The issue is. Parang I could no longer keep up dun sa mga sexual needs niya masyado. Kasi parang what he does to me is that when we're having sex, he'd eat me. As in, walang kamatayang kainan ito.
Tapos, oh my God!
Or I mean,
walang unlimited rice.
And then he counts all the time na magkakama ko. And nung una, 5 times, tapos naging 6, tapos naging 7. Yung gusto mag-record break, 25. Tapos in-expect niya mag-squirt ako na 25 times in what? In an hour?
Oh my gosh.
I'm sorry, okay. Ha? Talagang naguguluhan ako kasi
sabi mo,
yeah. Yung naman sa tao na to. Pero when it comes to doing it, parang ang hayo-hayo.
Yeah. No, he's malayo also with just the norm.
Realist, yeah. He's not realist.
Boy, this sounds like... And then how often does he... Are you guys having sex? Is it every day? Or I mean,
no, because he's a pilot there.
Kasi nga.
He's gone.
Okay, so we don't live together yet. Pero we see each other on a daily basis. So parang after his flight, he comes to my place or I go to his place. Tapos he expects na parang I touch... Parang high pa lang as he wants my hand on his thing.
Yeah, okay. That's what I was thinking. Sans, are you sure you don't want to rephrase the whole he's divine?
I know, it doesn't seem very divine to me.
Yeah, like you don't want to rephrase your way of thinking about him being so amazing and divine and lovely. I mean, are you sure? He sounds like a sex addict to me. He sounds like a fucking... I mean, he just...
Maybe the wife left him because of that. Yeah, not the other way around.
Maybe she's not coming because she's disgusted by him already.
You know, that's a good way of looking at it. Pero, kasi kasi yung itsura niya. Tapos, mahal ko naman.
Pogi talaga.
Parang gusto ko nang kausapin na parang medyo ilimit naman namin na mga 5 times lang yung mga request niya. Hindi naman 25 times.
Ikaw ba? Ano bang request mo?
Sans, I think you have a problem here. This is not something you talk through with the guy. This is a legitimate issue. In my opinion, this is a legitimate like problem he has. I mean, that's... If he wants you to score 25 times, and I mean, that's... This guy's fucking... He's uncontrollable, man. What else is he doing? Because a part of this is half of the time here I feel sorry for you and your vagina, and the other half I'm fucking so thrilled about hearing all of these things that this guy is involved in. What else does he do? Okay, so he eats you out like fucking like starving fucking orphans.
They don't serve food on the plane apparently
in conflict areas of Africa. And then secondly, what else does he do?
And okay. Hindi ko maintindihan bakit parang ito yung question ko eh. Ano bang satisfaction yung nakukuha niya pag naghihinamo siya ng cum ko sa mukha niya na hindi namin magagawa kung he's...
Wait! Time out! Did you just say that he washes your face with his cum?
She's being figurative.
No. She's being literal with this guy. Chopper, do not mistake any of this as some sort of figure of speech. Everything that comes out of her mouth is fucking literal. I shit you not.
He washes his face with your
cum?
Squirt?
Yeah.
Literally.
And he doesn't wash it off. It's like, if I tell him that
he doesn't wash it off
already, and he'd say, no, I want it to stay there. It lingers and stuff.
And then you're going to kiss him?
So sometimes I do.
Here's the kissing part. We're well beyond that it being a problem.
Sa kanya. Oh my God.
So he washes.
Exactly, kaya lang, parang, ano, natatakot naman ako na ma-offend siya. So,
what?
Parang, yeah, I take it in the right, parang in a stride na
lang. You're too nice. You're too nice.
Does he come on your face too?
No cock is that big to be too nice like that.
Does he come on your face also? Does he make you do things you don't want
to
do?
To come inside. So, parang mga one or two times palang that it comes on my face or, you know, any part of my body.
Awesome. All right. Okay.
Sans.
Well, here's the issue with this guy is a lot of this stuff he wants happen to him. He wants you to come on his face. He wants to eat you out so he can kind of splash that shit all over. It's a, you know, it's kind of like these guys you watch in, you know, these Japanese things where they want the girl to shit on them and all of that stuff.
Wala pa naman kami sa ganung point. And I don't
think darating ka doon tomorrow. I feel like that's going to happen.
Is he an international pilot or a domestic pilot?
I mean, quality naman siya. I mean, you know.
There's no
way. Wait. Let me stop you there. I don't see the quality in it except from, you know, the when you said he has a big cock, but it's not even worth it. Paano siya naging quality that you keep saying yes or agreeing to these things. When you tell us the moment that you see him, he wants your hand in his cock. Now, I don't see any chance for you guys to really spend quality time together apart from coming in his face.
Listen, love, I think you have a legitimate problem here, and I think you need to reevaluate how you think about this guy and how you feel about him. I mean, it was already a red flag when you said he left his wife because the wife couldn't come. I mean, that's a stupid thing. I mean, that
I'm sure that's not the whole story. Yeah,
that commitment you make to your wife is like it goes beyond the ability of her to not come on your face, and so he can fucking make hilamos in her fucking piss. I think you have a really big problem here, and you really need to fucking assess.
I mean, hindi ko nga ma-qualify kung love to or fascination lang kasi parang, well, you know, I'm 26 and he got me. I'm a virgin. So when he got me, he's like the first in everything.
He's your first.
Wow, talking about jumping into the
hardcore.
Deep end.
Hardcore.
Talking about jumping into the deep end.
You know,
good Lord.
So,
all right. Well,
alam mo yun, parang, hindi ko alam kung sabi nga ng mga friends ko parang ano parang I have this very close friend the girl na parang sabi niya you know I don't know why you keep up to it kasi parang binababoy ka na pero parang part of me naman parang okay parang hindi man okay pero nag-enjoy ka naman with what he does parang ganyan.
But it's gonna get weirder
sometimes na parang parang sobra.
Exactly. If you're at that point where you're thinking that, oh my gosh, what's going to be his next request or ganyan, I don't think that's a healthy sexual relationship even. Not just relationship in general. Like,
yeah. This is a tough one, man. But if you like it, who are we to say to stop? If you're really enjoying it and it's something that you're fascinated by, even if by a this is wild that you were a virgin and then this is your kind of first, your introduction to sex is a guy who wants you to come 25 times in his face and then all of that shit. That really is a unique situation, to be honest, love. But if it's something you enjoy, then I think you can stay with it. But I'm telling you, you have a problem here. This is a legitimate issue.
He has a problem.
And you know, it might jump into another female one day just because, for whatever reason.
Yeah, because I couldn't keep up anymore. Yeah,
absolutely.
You remember our caller from Australia was that before, and the boyfriend was also freaky like that. And
no, but this is different. Yeah, this is different.
This is different.
Yeah, she was freaky.
She was freaky as well.
This girl is like virgin, I don't know. Sounds normal.
Maybe you should.
I was able to like spill this out, parang to talk to you guys and to let you know. Because, parang, I mean, if sasabihin ko naman to sa alam mo yan, so friends
ang hirap sabihin sa ibang friends.
Unlike here na, you know.
Yes, yeah.
Good opinion coming from a female perspective and a male.
Yeah, I worry about you. Listen, okay, let's summarize. We got to go. I worry about you. I know this guy's got a legitimate issue, as I've said many times already. If this is something you're into, I don't know, maybe you read the Christian Grey shit and you're like, oh, this is so cool.
50 Shades of Grey.
But this is not.
No, 50 Shades of Grey doesn't even go like this.
No, but I mean like that freaky, crazy shit, super horny, off the wall stuff. Then, and if that's what you're thinking, then fine. But I'm just saying, this guy's got red flags all over. I mean, the clues are there. He is certainly not divine. He is certainly not lovely. But are we here to tell you to break up with him? No.
No.
But I'm telling you this. There are red flags. Ang daming warnings.
Super.
This is like, mayon is about to explode, pero yung mga tao pa rin, okay lang yan. Every year, but there's red shit falling down already. You know that thing when you look at the people who perish from calamities because they refuse to read
evacuate,
the signs?
Yeah.
That's what you're doing. You're not reading the signs. This is a calamity.
Where?
Yeah, this is a calamity that's going to explode. This is a calamity. This is something that's going to get, that you can be a victim from. Yeah. Easily.
And I think
easily
you're being attached also because he's your first one. You lost your virginity to him. And
well, no, maybe it's fascinating. It is fascinating. It's like, wow, this guy is so different. He's so
good. He's so good.
He's so into me.
So, yeah.
Like, look at him. He wants me so. He wants my piss. He wants this. He wants that. Parang, wow. Tanga na nagugutom to para sa mga bodily fluids. Napaka.
It's
almost flattering. Look at this. Puta, he can't handle you. He wants me so bad. It's not you. It's him. He needs anything so bad.
Yes.
Be careful.
Yeah, and the way you described him initially, and then when you went into detail as to how he is it doesn't match.
Scary. Sounds scary. I'll just tell you this. The signs are there. This volcano's going to erupt. This tsunami is gonna hit. Whatever you want to, it's time to evacuate. But if you don't want to evacuate, if you want to be one of those stubborn people who stays in their house,
it's up to you.
You will call us back because you're gonna be heartbroken.
Yeah.
Okay.
Call us back if he does something or requests something so wild.
Right. I want to know.
I want to know.
No, there's
coming.
More. There's more. Yeah. It's just we don't have time for it. All right, baby doll. Thanks for the call.
Thanks,
Mo. Good luck, Sans.
Thank you, Sans. Bye bye. Woo!
Ano yung sinabi niya? Kinakain
walang kamatayan.
Walang kamatayan, kainan.
We gotta take a break. When we come back, more calls. It's Good Times on Mother Podcast, Season 3, brought to you by Globe. Back after this.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
One thing I really love about music is I get to jam with so many different people. Collaboration comes naturally with musicians. Music should never be a limit or a barrier. It's a bridge. When Yolanda struck, I knew I needed to offer my talents and pitch in. So together with my team, we came up with this idea to do something wonderful for our country. What better way to sort of help out in our own way? We thought of the idea of Unwrap Hope, getting new toys. After a certain day, we bring it all to Parbok. Excited, but I don't really know what to expect. I just saw one whole cargo area full of toys, boxes and boxes of toys. So I am playing Santa Claus. That's what's happening today. I was just really excited just to get out there, seeing all the kids line up. They're very organized, and it was just really cute. But I just wanted to go out there and mingle. Just get in there, get in the mix.
May gift kami para sa inyo. May mga toys kami para sa mga kids. Sino may gusto ng toys? Yay! Mga kaibigan at mga kapatid namin sa Globe, noon pa man hindi nyo kami iniwanan. Alam ko na babangon uli yung mga Ormocanon. Alam ko na babangon uli ang mga Litenyo. Alam ko na babangon uli Sigaw at Kalinga.
When you're playing the children, I compare it to singing in front of family. It's just an honest thing. They sing along and they scream along and they dance along, and I love that.
come on 21st. That's probably the same feeling we will get on when we were kids, you know, 25th morning on Christmas Day. So we're bringing them an early Christmas gift. It goes both ways. That's what the season's all about. It's about giving back at this point, diba? And what more can I ask for when I do that? You know, when you're supposed to create something different or something special, then you're supposed to just let go, right? You just let go and let it happen, you know? And wherever it takes you, it's not about you anymore. It's something else that sort of inhabits you. You were able to create something bigger and better and special.
It's a wonderful world with Globe.
Please visit www.projectwonderful.ph to learn more.
What do you think is ailing local football?
Well, politics.
Should athletes be endorsers?
Yes, why not?
Why did you refuse to be the Haskell's head coach countless times?
I've been there, done that. Too much politics, like I said. Like I posted one time a few days ago, coaching is a thankless job. With what's happening with Michael Weiss, we talked about it already before, personally, one-on-one, and I said, it happens. And I said, you should know that because you worked also somewhere in other countries as well. There's no such thing as a permanent job in coaching, in any sport.
Why do you say thankless?
Well, you're only as good as the wins.
And then that's it.
Plus, of course, there are other factors like disrespect, honor, honesty, and all of this. Because you're just a coach, you're not the manager. You're not the association, you're not the institution. So you, as a coach, you're just an employee. So you're as good only as the wins that you have.
Two girls, one cup.
I heard there was this video going around on the internet some years ago.
Because we're two girls, me and Nicole, and a cup where we get all our topics from the cup.
It's not lustful.
The show is about shoes, bags, friends, girlfriends, gossip,
current events,
everyday life.
I don't know. Dicks on my head, apparently.
And the dick on Nicole's head. We got a segment called Let's Be Honest.
Would you do whoever? Would you do Max Eigenmans? I would. Cisco, because there's a bro code, but there's no written Cisco. Truth or dare, kupal people.
Bullshit.
We share pussy. Not really. Two girls, one cup. You should watch the show.
Everything looks great, HQ. CDCP looks fine.
Remember, your powers come from the signal feeds from cell towers, so make sure you stay within reach.
I'll be fine, HQ. There are more than 7,000 Globe cell sites scattered across country. See? I see one right there. What's the problem over there? I'll go check it out.
Be careful, Agent CT. If you need any assistance...
HQ.
Agent.
HQ, do you read me?
Respond, Agent CT. Do you copy? What's your status?
Agent,
do you
copy?
You copy. Your status.
HQ! Where am I?
Thank you.
There seems to be no signal tower in this village. My signal senses are tingling. What to do? What to do? Aha! I know agency! Oh, yeah. I forgot. I don't have powers here. Noble citizen!
Noble citizen!
Secure permission.
Secure permission!
To the Homeowners Association meeting.
Homeowners Association Office.
Excuse me.
Okay, on to other issues. Cell phone signals. We're here to answer questions.
Oh, great. Just the proper form. Let's go.
We finalized today. Any more concerns? Yes.
Good afternoon, all. On cell sites, we need to set up a cell site within this village.
We don't need that.
Your laptops, your cell phones, your tablets, they feed on signal for them to work. You see, it does not even have to look like a cell site. It just has to look like it belongs.
But what about the health risks?
Yeah, fear not. Several studies show that the radio frequency signals used by these cell sites do not affect your health. It's just like the frequency used by baby monitors, AM and FM radios, your Wi-Fi. Completely harmless. Think about
That's
it.
That's exactly what we need.
Without wireless communication, how will you stay updated? How will you talk to your loved ones who are abroad?
Yeah.
How will you remind your kids to take care and to come home early?
That's right. We need a cell site. I agree. I'm going to call my father now.
Yeah, that's exactly what we need.
Thank you, thank you.
No, thank you, random citizen.
I want a cell site right now.
I agree.
Super Agent CZ!
See? True power lies within each citizen. Signal connects us. Together, we will make more villages a more comfortable place to live in. I guess my mission here is done.
Oh, great. We thought we lost you, Agent CT.
That's Super Agent CT now!
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the podcast, it is Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 3, brought to you by Globe. On the show tonight, Angelicopter. You can follow her on Twitter at the Angelicopter. Thanks for being here, Chopper. It's nice to have you back.
Thanks for having me.
Maybe we can have you back on next Friday.
We'll see.
Wow, sorry. I'm just kind of squeezing something.
I'll abuse you and schedule that.
478-7954, Skype, The Good Times Podcast. You can text us 0927-214-1981. Last chance for your calls here because we're running out of time on this Friday night. Let's go ahead. Wait, don't I have an announcement to say? Did you guys send me an announcement?
Yes, please.
Of course, we need to have the greatest experience we get as customers. You agree?
Yes, of course.
Well, because we deserve it. That's why I was so excited to know that Globe's home broadband, Tattoo Home, brings innovative and new options that give us the best online experience. Visit tattoo.globe.ph for details. Checking it right now, and I can say that this is real value for my money. Please do give it a look. Again, it is tattoo.globe.ph. Let's get some calls. Let's start with line 5 and talk to Stoner, who is 24 in Las Pinas. Stoner, is that your name because you, in fact, are a stoner?
Hi.
You smoke a lot of weed? Yes, Stoner?
Hi.
Hi. You do a lot of drugs?
Yeah. Hi daw siya, hi.
Yeah. You do a lot of drugs?
No. I'm just a bit nervous. I mean, it's not every time that I get to talk to you, so.
Yeah.
So you chose the name Stoner.
Yeah, it's fun. Yeah. All right, Stoner, you're 24. Yes. In the South. Yes, How can we help you? Mm. What's your question?
Hello?
Yes, what's your question?
Okay. So, I've got some issues. It started about 2 years ago, and well, my longtime partner had a relationship with an office mate, although it didn't last very long. But the thing was, kahit totally okay na kami ng partner ko, not to mention, I can tell naman that he did change a lot. The other woman is still bugging me, like she would flood my blog with lots of negative comments and stuff. Like, tell our common friends I was, you know, stupid and stuff. Tell people a lot of lies about me. At first, it was okay, but, you know, it's been going on for a couple of years now. So, I think hindi lahat ng oras magpapasensya ka. So, the problem is that gusto
time
ko siyang,
for a sabonuta.
How do I say? Gusto ko siyang patulan at least for once, pero in such a way na I won't stoop down to her level or something.
No, you can stoop down.
Yeah, it's okay to stoop down.
Yeah, it's always good. It's fun, actually, to stoop down to her. But your question is what? Revenge? This is a revenge call?
He has revenge in, you know...
Yes, po.
Not...
yes, po. Gusto ko po
na
parang revenge.
Ang cheap nung dating. Parang ganun. So, I don't know how to do it. Pero siguro, I just want her to stop kasi it's been 2 years. So, hindi lahat ng oras magpapasensya ka. So, yeah, I gotta do something. Parang ganun.
Yung mga hindi YouTube okay. level and here's, the mall.
Here's my thing. Why do you have to do it and why isn't your boyfriend doing something about it? Stoner.
Hello? I'm sorry.
Yeah, why isn't your boyfriend doing anything about it?
Yung bata.
Little kids laughing at your ass. Yeah. Why isn't your boyfriend doing something about it?
Pwede pa ulit po ng question.
Okay, one more time. Yung boyfriend mo.
I mean, yung question mo kanina, sorry.
Yeah, what's my question?
Why is your...
Yeah.
Bakit hindi inaayos ng boyfriend mo yung problema na yan? Bakit ikaw?
It was, well, actually, okay naman na siya. Pero we've got some common friends, so, you know, sometimes may mababalitaan kang sinabi ni ganito, na ganito ka daw, and sometimes mag-weave ng stories about you na hindi naman totoo. And I just decided na hindi na lang siguro sabihan ng partner ko na.
Hindi ganito. Sinabi mo ba?
Magsisimula lang siya ulit ng communication between them. So,
so that's why you don't want to tell your boyfriend kasi...
Yes. Parang ayaw ka lang na magkaroon ulit ng communication. So, I tried to deal on my own. Kaso, 2 years na and hindi nga tumitigil. So, I don't know how to... I don't know
I had a situation before the ex-girlfriend of my boyfriend was calling my house and also my mom. Mm. So I told my boyfriend, if you don't fix that, I'm breaking up with you.
It'd be nice if he fixes it instead of you fixing it. Even though it generates conversation between him and her, it's like a necessary conversation that needs to happen. And I think that really is the way to go.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not your problem as much as...
It's his.
As it is his as well. And I think it's something that he has to
deal with.
Address.
Go ahead.
Yeah, he has to address.
Either way.
That's all you have to say. Your ex-girlfriend is bugging me. I've really tried to be patient about it, but it's come to a point where nakakainis na kasi she's also bugging my friends. So, kung hindi mo ayusin yan, then I'm breaking up with you.
Yeah.
That's it. Ganun lang kadali. Sabi mo.
Yes. Well...
Tell her to stop, and if she doesn't stop, we're breaking up.
Medyo hot-tempered yung partner ko. So, parang ang nangyari is, may na-involve na boyfriend yung dating ex. So, parang ang mangyayari, knowing my partner, alam kong magkakaroon ng gulo na sobrang parang suntukan or something. Ayoko nang ganun lang.
Then great.
Then so what? So, okay lang yun. Basta hindi ikaw yung masusuntok.
I mean,
don't be there.
I mean, kasi iba yung... Like, for example, sabihin ko yung partner ka na to tell the person to stop bugging me, especially dun sa blog ko sa websites kasi nagpo-post ng mga negative comments and stuff. Pero parang naging it started as a simple issue between the three of us. Tapos, ayun, syempre may mga fraternities and stuff sa nagsusumbong, ganyan-ganyan, blah, blah. So, I do not want to complicate things as much as possible.
Masyadong madrama.
Yes, I mean, in pa, my part, simple lang. I just want her to stop.
She's
but
not gonna
then,
stop.
Hindi ko in-expect na maraming ang, like, as she calls it, connection daw, ganyan, mga fraternity. So, if mangyari na parang
don't you just want another boyfriend that doesn't come with all these extra
yeah,
baggage?
Well, why don't you just get yourself another boyfriend? It just seems like this is a little too much to this is going to take over the fun in the relationship.
Yeah, it's like mm-hmm. you have more
all of a sudden you have less to gain being with this guy than you have to gain. Let's look for a new boyfriend, huh?
Mm-hmm. Look for a new boyfriend that doesn't have a crazy ex-girlfriend. Or that didn't cheat on you. Yung ganon. Yung mas masaya. Yung romantic. Yung idea of your movie date.
When you're not getting more than your... Like, I guess everything is a balance here. There are negative situations to be in and positive situations. Once the negatives start to take over 51% of whatever's going on, it's time to break up with that person. Like, there are negative people, there are positive people, right, in this world. And many of us will interact with people who are kind of just have shit all the time, and there are people who have good things that happen all the time. Once negative things start to get past that 51% of the time that person's negative or negative things happen to that person, then it's time to leave. Because then you're talking about an unhappy existence.
I think that's part of him that I have to accept. I mean, it's been 8
years.
No,
you don't have to accept it.
You can accept 49% and below.
Oh, shit.
No, he's a better person this time. It's just that there was, you know, some things in his past na sila na lang yung ayaw tumigil. So, leaving my partner is not an option.
I know, but it's
actually.
I know, but why is it not an option?
Okay, here's what. Okay, this is ultimately this is what it comes down to, love. It's either you're gonna deal with it or you're not gonna deal with it. Dealing with it meaning you just stay there while she continues to verbally or at least online abuse you and cyberbully you and whatever the fuck. She can continue to do that, or you don't deal with it by telling her. Sorry, telling your boyfriend he has to step up and
to
do something. Now, we have cyberbully laws now and all of that stuff. This is a great way to introduce yourself and to society to the effects of online bullying. I think that this could be a nice little issue for you. If you want to contact your lawyer and say, hey, listen, we have a cyberbullying law. Is this qualify as being illegal and stuff like that? And you can, so there's no more suntukan, there's no more fraternity. Your lawyer will send a letter over to her and say, Miss Super Bitch, if you are not aware, it's been all over the news. What you are doing now is illegal. This is our fucking contact information. Cease and desist or face the legal consequences.
Or turn off the freaking comment option on your blog.
I can't do that. I have a blog. I can't do that.
No, well.
You can't do that. Why not do this part? I don't understand. Why not have a lawyer friend of yours write up some bullshit letter saying, this is now illegal. You know that. It's all over the news. Continue to do so. And I dare you because this is what's going to happen. Wala nang suntukan, hindi na kailangan magsuntukan, hindi na kailangan magfrat or any of these things. Or ramble or whatever the fuck you guys do in those frats.
I know.
Just easily take what the law gives you. It's a very trendy, high-profile law right now. And send it over to her.
I can't believe fraternities bother with this kind of issue.
Well, they do when they're young. Well, how old is she? 24? Yeah, I think they grow up by now. But I think that's the way to go. Okay? It's the way to go.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, no, that's the way to go.
That's what you need to do. Just go ahead and send that letter over to her. Okay? And see if she'll stay. All right?
Yeah, thank
you. All right. And then, you know, make a blog entry about it. This is what's going on in my life. You understand. You guys read my comments. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put the cyberbullying law to the test. And you send it out there. You tell your other friends to retweet it. I'll fucking retweet it for you. Whatever. And get, you know, garner a little bit of attention from it because you might be one of the first ones who are actually going to file a case using the law. And that's going to get some press. Well, maybe it'll get some press. It'll get some press from me. It might get press from,
Rappler.
Yeah, who knows? This might be a classic example of how a girl getting bullied online is going to fight back.
and see if the new cyberbullying law works.
And then the news is going to get to it, and all of a sudden you've got a nice little issue on your hands.
Yeah. So it's better than the rape case that he scored down about, yeah. That's for sure.
Okay. So I suggest you do that. If you have a lawyer friend, ask them. If you don't have a lawyer friend, get one. This might be a really good thing. You might even find a lawyer friend willing to do it for free because it's such a high-profile thing.
the law, yeah.
The law is it's a really big deal right now. So if it's a big deal, exploit that. Use this girl for it. That's what I would do.
So thank you, anyway.
Thank you, Stoner. All right. Have a good day.
Thank you,
thanks,
Mo.
Love. Good luck. No worries. Bye-bye. All right, one last call. We're running out of time here. Sheena, you are on line 6. Hi, Sheena. You've been on hold for an hour and a half.
Hi. Hey. Hi, DJ Mo.
Hi, Sheena.
I am just curious about your perspective about my general question, which is, what is the craziest thing you ever did for love?
I mean, that's a tough one. Like,
Are you at the brink of making a decision?
Really stupid?
Just a random question.
Oh, so it's like a craziest.
It's like an interview question. DJ Mo, what's the craziest thing you've done for love?
It's just a broad question. Don't we all do stupid? Don't we all do lots of crazy stupid things?
I know, but
things?
They couldn't have asked the.
What?
Nothing.
No, what?
What? No, I mean, see, DJ Mo does a lot of stuff for love.
How do you know that shit?
Kinukwento mo before sa fence station.
No, I mean, it's not that crazy. I think everyone has done a little bit of, that's what I'm saying. It's like, it's such a wild, weird question because we all do something stupid.
Doesn't mean always stupid.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, thing for love. Like, it could be like the biggest thing you've done for love, but doesn't mean it's stupid.
Most crazy things that I would do revolve around, like, having the ability to spend to do it. Like, I don't do any, like, you know, it would have to be something that dealt with something expensive because that's where you can go out and do something really crazy, whether it be like a trip of some sort, you know, to like, oh, okay, let's go and do a weekend in this very far off land or something like that. I mean, those are generally the crazy things. It tends to get really expensive. I'm trying to think of something creative that's within, I guess, within normal reach. I mean, that's not so crazy and stupid. And what would that be, Chopper?
I don't know.
I don't know, man. It's such a weird question because it's not a problem, and I'm not in the crazy.
What's
spend a lot of money on somebody?
Sheena, what's something you would want a guy to do for you that you think is crazy?
But see, even you're having a hard time asking the question because it's such a weird.
I know.
I don't know what to say. It would have to do with something spending a lot of money on to for something to happen. That's what I would think is the craziest thing. That's the thing is you're not convinced because the question is so flawed. I don't know how to answer that. It's like you're asking us, what's your favorite meal of all time? It's like, who the fuck? I don't know. Was it when I was pinaka hungry or was it truly the greatest meal I've ever? It's a very difficult question to ask. Which movie do you like better? Titanic or... Saw 4. I don't know. Why do you want me to answer that? It's such a difficult question. Craziest thing I've done for love, it has to be, if anything, something that revolved around spending an incredible amount of money for it. Because to me, that's always what equates to crazy. Whether it means I'm mukhang pera or I have a value for money, it is probably something like that.
Money like buying a stuff for your girlfriend.
Yeah, either buying them something or going somewhere expensive and experiencing something expensive and nice. That's generally what I would consider crazy. Other people would think, skydiving with my girlfriend is crazy. But see, I'm not into that shit. I'm not into the adrenaline rush stuff. So you understand why it's so difficult to answer the question is because what's crazy for me might be normal for someone, or what's crazy for me might not be capable or might even be realistic for another person. If you gave me a little bit more specific thing to work
situation,
then I can answer it. But I can't answer such a broad general question right now, I would have to sit down and go, gee, what is the craziest thing I've done for love? Oh, maybe I picked up my girlfriend from her work and my car broke down. So, linakaran ko lang. I mean, you get what I mean? It's so difficult to answer this question. Let me ask Chopper. Let's see if she can come up with something great. Chopper, what's the craziest thing you've done for love?
I don't know.
See?
I can't qualify anything I've done like crazy. I mean,
thank God you got disconnected. I was like, how am I going to fucking end this call? I'm not convinced. Jesus, I don't know. Well, fuck. What do you want me to tell you? And on that note, time to wrap it up. I want to thank all the calls. We had a lot of good calls. Boy, it's going to be tough. Who's going to be caller of the night tonight? Speaking of, the winner for caller of the night will win VIP passes to see Macklemore and Ryan Lewis live in Manila. March 16th.
What about Dom from Zabel?
Yeah, there's that, but I like the
Daniel teacher.
Yeah, but there's one more I like. I'm gonna go through these calls and find out who's gonna be back after this.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I like the
Agent CT, what's your status?
Everything looks great, HQ. CDCP looks fine.
Remember, your powers come from the signal feeds from cell towers, so make sure you stay within reach.
I'll be fine, HQ. There are more than 7,000 globe cell sites scattered across country. See? I see one right there. What's the problem over there? I'll go check it out.
Be careful, Agent CT. If you need any assistance...
HQ.
Agent.
HQ, do you read me?
Respond, Agent CT. Do you copy? What's your status?
Do you copy?
Your status.
HQ! Where am I? There seems to be no signal tower in this village. My signal senses are tingling. What to do? Aha! I know!
Agent
CT! Oh yeah. I forgot. I don't have powers here. Normal citizen! Seek your permission to the homeowners association meeting.
Homeowners association office.
Excuse me.
Okay, on to other issues. Cell phone signals. We're here to answer questions.
Oh, great. Just the proper form. Let's go.
We finalized today. Any more concerns? Yes.
Good afternoon, all. On cell sites, we need to set up a cell site within this village.
We don't need that.
Your laptops, your cell phones, your tablets. They feed on signal for them to work. You see, it does not even have to look like a cell site. It just has to look like it belongs.
What about the health risk?
Yeah, fear not. Several studies show that the radio frequency signals used by these cell sites do not affect your health. It's just like the frequency used by baby monitors, AM and FM radios, your Wi-Fi. Completely harmless. Think about
it. That's exactly what we need.
Without wireless communication, how will you stay updated? How will you talk to your loved ones who are abroad?
Yeah.
How will you remind your kids to take care and to come home early?
That's right. We need a cell site.
No, thank you, random citizen.
I want a cell site right now.
I agree.
Super Agent CD!
See? True power lies within each citizen. Signal connects us. Together, we will make more villages a more comfortable place to live in. I guess my mission here is done.
Oh, great. We thought we lost you, Agent CT.
That's Super Agent CT now!
So she hates me?
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Time to wrap it up tonight. I want to thank all our callers. We appreciate you guys so very much. As well as people that download this program. Of course, our staff that does such a great job. And Angelicopter for being here on this Friday night as we wrap up the month of February. It is time to do Caller of the Night. And tonight's prize is VIP passes to watch Macklemore and Ryan Lewis in concert. This is happening on March 16th at the MOA Arena. Of course, brought to you by Concertus. And you can still win these tickets on my blog as well. So it's motwister.ph. If you don't win tonight, you can also win there for the next couple of weeks. Plus, I'm giving away some Kobe shoes from Titan 22. I want to thank Titan 22 for that. All of that happening every week on motwister.ph. Plus, I'm throwing reviews out there, and interviews, and all that good stuff. So please do check out my site when you can. Chopper.
Yes.
Caller of the night. Who are we going with? I know you said you wanted the dumb.
I know, but
I was saying, what about the girl who got
Sans.
The face full of fucking cum?
Yeah. Yeah. Sans.
So let's go with Sans as caller of the night. She's the one with the pilot boyfriend that eats her pussy 25 times a night.
An hour.
An hour.
Yeah. Yeah. Walang kamatayang kainan is her term. Nice.
What if she just stops washing?
You know, I was gonna say, why don't you just let him go down on you when you have your period or something? Like, don't tell him.
No, but the period thing, I think he'll even continue. He'll push through.
Yeah?
Yeah. I just like, just be disgusting. So I just like, don't wash it.
No, but he's disgusting. He doesn't
like
even
right
wash
before
his...
right before he arrives in your condo, like tomae ka pero wag ka magpunas. But when he's like, ooh, this is on my chin. Die. That's awesome.
No, it's going to drive his wild, crazy mind.
No, next thing he's going to love it. He's going to be like, oh my God, she's one of me.
Yeah, she likes this shit, literally.
Tain mo sa mouth. So let's go ahead and give that to her. We'll see you guys on Monday. Have a great weekend, everybody. Thanks again for being part of our show. Let's get out of here. This podcast is being brought to you by Globe. Have a good night, everyone.
Night.
Bye.
Good Times with Mo, the podcast season 3, was brought to you by Globe.
We'd like to thank you for your calls and invite you to check out our other podcast on the New Media Factory by logging on to nmftv.com.
Follow Good Times with Mo on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
Follow Mo at DJ Mo Twister. And don't forget to check out www.motwister.ph.
See you next time.
The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.